Hello students, today we will discuss about reproduction. We have earlier seen the definition of reproduction, its significance, types of reproduction, asexual and sexual reproduction, and difference in between them. In our today's topic, we will see the rest of the type of asexual reproduction. We had already seen about binary fission, multiple fission, and two types of budding, external and internal budding. Now today we will discuss about another type of asexual reproduction. This is spore formation. It's a very common phenomena in fungi. A spore is a microscopic cell which contains a nucleus with a small mass of cytoplasm surrounded by a protective coat. This structure is formed in a very specific structure, that spore keeping structure is known as sporangia fruiting body, that is usually formed in fungi. This is, suppose this one is a fungal thread, it's a multinucleated structure. Somewhere one evagination of protoplasm is formed in which one nuclei can be entered very easily. After some time, the structure is developed into a club-shaped structure, and that structure is responsible to make spores in it. So the spore-keeping structure is known as sporangia. By this projection, you can see a club-shaped structure. Now what this nuclei will do? That undergoes in division, and because of that, multiple nuclei are formed inside of this structure. Now the sporangia is filled by minute nuclei. Now at the last, cytoplasmic division also takes place, and every nuclei is surrounded by a little bit amount of cytoplasm. At the last of the formation of this structure, a membrane is formed that will bind the whole structure. As soon as the favorable condition comes, the structure will burst and release all the spores out of the body. It's a burst sporangia that is responsible to release all the spores. Now these spores will behave like seeds, and they will germinate in the presence of water, air, and will form new fungal hyphae. This spore keeping structure is sporangia. So I am going to tell about spore formation again. It's very common in fungi. So I can write the example here. As I told you, spore is a microscopic structure. This is the fungal hyphae that can form a cytoplasmic projection in which a nuclei can be inserted. As soon as this nuclei is inserted, that will form a club shaped structure where, first of all, nucleus division will take place, so this nuclei will divide into multiple of nuclei, and later on every nuclei is surrounded by cytoplasm, because after karyokinesis cytokinesis will take place. So I can write the terms here. This one is a karyokinesis, that means nuclear division, while the second step, that is ternary, cytokinesis, cytoplasmic division. And because of cytoplasmic division, you can say various cytoplasmic fragments are formed, which is actually surround every nuclei, and at the last of this action, plasma membrane is formed. Now whenever favorable condition come, the sporangia get burst and all the spores are free. Now in the favorable condition, like in the presence of water and the presence of oxygen, they get germinate and give rise to new. This is the mode of asexual reproduction that is usually done in fungi. The next kind of asexual reproduction is also known as regeneration. It's regeneration, that means again and again generation. That's usually done in the filamentous algae. A very common example of filamentous algae is spirogyra. Spirogyra, this is the filamentous algae, which is usually found in fresh water. Whenever this filament strike or is if there is any physical injury that can be done by the striking of this alga on a rock, and you can see this alga can be fragmented into various parts. Here every fragment is capable to form new spire. This is the ability of regenerate. Now every fragment that can form new spire, whether it's a 4 cell or 5 cell or 10 cell, 50 cell keeping structure, but they have ability to regenerate. So actually, what is the meaning of regeneration? It's an ability to regain the lost part. Here this ability is extended up to the regaining of whole the life. It's a new Spirogyra here and another new spire. This ability is also found in various animals like Planaria, Hydra, etc. The next category of asexual reproduction is also known as vegetative propagation. What do you mean by vegetative propagation? It's a mode of propagation where reproduction is done by the vegetative plant part. It's a specific kind of reproduction that only occurs in plants. That can be done naturally and artificial manner. First of all, we will talk about natural vegetative propagation. This can be done in various plants. They may be angiosperm or gymnosperm. This can be done by root, by leaf, and by stem also. So these all the parts are vegetative plant parts, which are actually not related with reproduction, but in the case of vegetative reproduction, they contain some specific structure for reproduction. Like if I'm talking about sweet potato, it's a root. Suppose this one is the root of sweet potato. It contains some specific structure which are known as adventitious buds, and these adventitious buds are related with reproduction. Just like that, potato, in potato tuber you can see various green structures. In a simple manner we can say these are eyes. Actually these are adventitious buds which are again related with reproduction. This is also found in leaves. Some plant leaves contain such a kind of adventitious bud at the margin of leaf. When these leaves fall down, these buds get germinated and will form new individuals. I am going to write the example that we have discussed. This is the root of sweet potato, while this is the leaf of bougainvillea. Or you can, one more example I can give, it's bryophyllum leaf. While this one is the potato. Well, the second category is called as artificial vegetative propagation. In this category, the development of new plant is done by artificially with the help of root, stem or leaf. Usually we will take the stem part. That is done by cutting. In this process, usually hard tissue are taken. That's a very common process in sugarcane. Suppose this one is the stem of sugarcane. Here the stem can be cut into various pieces So this, and here every piece will work as a seed, and after sowing you will get a new. Second phenomenon is called as grafting, where one plant is grafted over another, and that's why you can get different kind of plants, different kind of flowers on a plant. Suppose this one is a rose plant that can give rise to yellow rose, and this is the plant that can give rise to red rose. I can take a twig of red flower and can implant it on yellow flower. So I can indicate this one is a plant A and this is plant B. Here I am going to implant plant A on plant B. For making this junction strong, first of all I have to make a V-shaped wedge in it, and just like that the last end of plant A can be made as V shape now. Now after some time both the plant will join together. Here the rooted plant is known as, a specific term is also given. This rooted plant, this is known as stalk, while this is known as cell. The implanted portion, that is cell. After some time both the parts will join together and will work like a plant. Third technique is known as layering, where a plant branch is pegged down so that it can give rise to, usually a lower branch is taken. This is pegged down in such a way that a part of branch remain in the contact with soil, while the rest of the part can be easily found in air. After some time, this plant part will generate its own root. And at that moment, this can be easily separate out and work as a new individual. Now I can cut this branch and this plant part can work as a new individual. This kind of layering can be done in jasmine. And just like that, that grafting can be easily done in rose plant, and cutting can be easily done in sugar cane. So it's over about the asexual reproduction now. Thank you everyone.